Hello everyone, thank you very much for coming to my channel. There is a lot of competition on YouTube, so I really appreciate that you come to my channel. And this video is going to be devoted to two words. The first word is Lenin and the second word is Belarus. Let's go. I decided to make this video because I live in America, but I was born in Belarus and I still have a heart and love to this country, which is my native land. Nowadays, the opposition leader from Belarus, Svetlana Tikhanovskaya, she's in America right now. She's visiting Washington, D.C. On Sunday, she will be in New York and she's visiting the White House, speaking with Secretary of State and other senators about democracy in Belarus. As you know, in Belarus, we have a dictator, Alexander Lukashenko, who is in power in Belarus since 1994. And the reason that I brought Lenin to this story is because still in Belarus, we have 400 monuments in Belarus, and the best places of each town, like a square or a central park or something like that, still there is a monument to Lenin. I don't know how for you, but for me, this is very interesting because, you know, Lenin is a very controversial figure. In 1917, he was the leader of a revolution in Russia and he helped the working class to get power from the Tsar, from the king of Russia. Interesting fact, people were fighting for freedom, for their rights against the Tsar, against the king in Russia, with the help of Lenin and his ideas. But in the end of the day, as you know, Soviet Union and the power that brought Lenin to everybody was even more harsh and more strict than to compare with the Russian Tsar or Russian king. In August 2020 was last elections of the president of Belarus, and Alexander Lukashenko claimed that he won the election. But all the society, all the people who live in Belarus, they disagree. They said that everybody voted for Svetlana Tikhanovskaya, who was the leader of the opposition, and all the elections was not fair. Everybody went to the streets. Sometimes in the capital of Minsk was 500,000 people on the streets protesting the results of the elections. But people, the government, they use force and they just smashed their protest. Everybody was put in jail, everybody was beaten up, some people died, shots were fired sometimes. It was horrible. It was 1 month of craziness. And I was looking at this, I was observing all these things from the United States, and now we have Svetlana Tikhanovskaya, the opposition leader who won the elections, but she was forced to leave the country, and now she's promoting her ideas regarding the future of Belarus in the West, in European Union, and also in the United States. As I said before, she's in the United States right now. She's in Washington, D.C. On Sunday, she will be in New York. And I have very interesting idea. And during the meeting with her on Sunday that I'm planning to attend, I'm going to ask her following question. What do you think? When everybody was protesting, and even today, maybe if we fight against this symbol, this monument in each city in Belarus, we have Lenin. If we remove this monument, if we just destroy this monument, maybe we can look to the future of Belarus in another way. Because imagine the following thing. In 2016, brand new monument to Lenin was built in Minsk, in the capital. What does it mean? So the government of the city, they invested money, they approved the taxpayer money to be spent to build a new monument to Lenin. And as you know, Lenin is a figure. Nowadays, we know that his most popular word was расстрелять in Russian, which means shoot this person. So he was very radical. He was approving a lot of death. He was At the beginning, he was like a big fan of Marxist ideas, like a socialism for the Russia, you know. But then, the end of the day, we got terror, T-E-R-R-O-R. So people were killed on the streets just for not being agree with the secret police of the Soviet Union. Until this day, we have this person as his monument in each city in Minsk, in Brest, in Gomel, in Vitebsk. Everywhere you go, there is Lenin in the street. I made a very interesting experiment. I went to my mother, she lives in the United States, and I asked her, what is your opinion? What do we need to do with the monument of Lenin, who is in our native city? And she said, you know what? We need to keep this monument. And I said, why? And she said, listen, this is our past, this is our history, so we need to preserve it. And I told her, listen, what about like just making a museum about this and educating that it was a history of Belarus, but it was bad? She said, I don't know. So in my opinion, in order to win the government who is a dictator right now in Belarus, Lukashenko, we need to start from destroying the monuments for the Lenin. Because Lenin, his ideas were actually terrorism, you know. It wasn't for democracy. He wasn't thinking about happiness of the people. He was just paying the price of the death of his older brother. He was angry person. He hated the Tsar, the king of Russia. And that's why from his international immigration in Switzerland, he helped to create the revolution in Russia. You know what? In Belarus, the Soviet Union wasn't that strict like in Moscow, for example, or in Russia. Not that many people were killed during the Stalin time. Not a lot of poets or writers were put in jail as to compare with Russia, for example, or Ukraine. People didn't starve to death like in Ukraine in the 30s. In Belarus, Soviet Union was very, very soft. So that's why people kind of looking at the Soviet time as like a happy time, but at the same time everybody agreed that it was a lot of lie, was a lot of oppression, and nobody was happy. But till this day we have Lenin monument in Belarus in each city. So my suggestion to the opposition, to the activists, to the political leaders of the new Belarus, we need to start from destroying the monuments of Lenin. And that can change the subconscious idea of the people in general, because people every day they go to work, they go to the store, they go to the supermarket, they go just to visit the river, and they pass by the real big monument of Lenin. And people just don't pay attention to this. But how you can be angry for having a dictator, a communist, a person who likes violence against those own people? How you can be critical to him if in each city we have Lenin as the main guy of the city, as the monument? You know, of course, that's why we have communistic power in Belarus. So that's why I have this idea, if we start destroying the monuments of Lenin in each city in Belarus, we can have some kind of an attempt to bring some kind of new reality in Belarus. I would like to know what you think about this. This video, of course, is for people who are interested in Belarus, who are interested in communism, in the history, and also in the political activities overseas, not in the United States. So please write in comment what you think about this. It will be very useful to start the conversation like that. Also, Belarus is a very bad example to the neighbor, Russia. Imagine we have the following thing. In the capital of Minsk, in the center of the city, there is a KGB building. And across the street, there is a monument to Felix Dzerzhinsky, the guy who invented the KGB in the 20s in Soviet Union. And Russia, they pay attention to this, and look at this. They brought Dzerzhinsky monument back to Moscow, which was destroyed in the beginning of the 90s. So Belarus is a crazy place. We have monuments to Lenin all over the place, and also it's the only Russian-speaking republic where people still have official holiday on 7th of November, which is the Revolution Day. During the Soviet Union time, it was the biggest holiday. It was the whole city was celebrating 7th of November, the day of the revolution. It's still as a holiday in Belarus. Can you imagine on 7th of November, people don't work, everybody celebrate, and the government is saying in the newspapers, everybody needs to be congratulated with this revolution day. I don't know why, but the opposition leaders, that's what they need to focus on killing this Soviet Union memorabilia, like people say in America. Lenin, revolution. Imagine, the most beautiful prospect, the most beautiful avenue in my native city of Borisov is still called Avenue of Revolution. So can you imagine, Avenue of Revolution in 2021? And people think, why in Belarus there is still a dictator, communistic style Lukashenko in power? Thank you very much for watching this video. I hope it was useful for you. And as I said earlier, please let me know in comments what you think. Belarus and Lenin, and is it a big deal in fighting for the freedom, democracy, and against the dictatorship? Thank you very much for watching this video. If you're first time on my channel, please subscribe to my channel. I'm promising you delivering interesting content. And also, if you like this video, put like. If you dislike this video, if you hate something, put dislike. It's also very important. Stay tuned.